Hello everyone and welcome to another video. So today in this video we are doing the charging test of the Poco X3. As you can see, this is the Poco X3, and today in this video we are doing the charging test with the charger that came in the box. So this is the cable that also came in the box, and we are going to be using the charger that also came in the box. So if you look at the charger from close up, and if the camera focuses, you can see that this is the output on this charger is rated at 5 volt 3 amperes, 9 volt 3 amperes, 12 volt 2.25 amperes, 20 volt 1.35 amperes and 11 volt 3 amperes. This is a fairly big charger, one of the biggest charger that I've seen in the phones that I've used. So here is the Poco X3, here is the charger. Let me just plug in an extension. So here I've got my extension. I've plugged this extension in the inverter because I don't want the power cutoff in the middle of the test. And I will also be running a small timer on the other phone. So let me just plug this in and see what is the voltage it takes from the charger. So I've got my USB meter here. Now this is an old meter. I'm not even sure whether this meter will be able to measure the accurate rating of this charger or not. But let's just see what happens. So let me just connect this in. So the meter is now connected, and as you can see, it is displaying 5.2 volt. Let me plug in the phone and let's see what is the voltage and what is the current this phone takes. This is the Poco X3. So first let us plug in our phone, and I'm not going to remove the cover because it's a hassle to remove the cover every time you want to charge your phone. So I will keep the cover on, and that will give us a more reasonable charging time using this charger. So the phone is now plugged in, and let me show you that it is at 1%. So as you can see on the top, the phone is at 1%. Let me plug in the USB meter and let's see what is the current it takes. So it's plugged in, and as you heard, the phone is charging. At the moment it is taking 7 volt 1.7 amp. Let's wait for a second and let's see what is the maximum watt it takes. And at the moment it is taking, the phone is taking 14 watts from the charger. So this meter is reading 14 watt. Let me try another meter because I'm not sure whether this meter is completely correct or not. So let me bring in another meter. So here is another meter. Let's just try this meter as well and see whether we're getting different readings with this one or not. So as you can see, the meter turned on. Let me plug this in as well. So again, you heard the charging time, sorry, the charging bell, and it is taking 8 volt, 1.7 amp. So as you can see, still taking 14 watt in the meter. Now I'm not sure whether this meter is causing some problem or not, because this is a very old meter. Maybe this meter is not supporting the fast charging that this phone supports. Anyways, let me just remove the meter and continue with our charging test. So let's remove everything, plug in our phone in the charger. As you can see, the phone is now charging. Let's start a timer. Now we'll come back after 10 minutes. As you can see, after 10 minutes, the phone is at 23%. We'll come back after 20 minutes. So as you can see, after 20 minutes, the phone is at 43%. Let's come back after 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, the phone is at 57%. And after 30 minutes, I'm holding the phone is not heating up. It's just a little bit warm. Remember, we started at 1%. So that is something I want you to remember. So as you can see, after 30 minutes, the phone is at about 57%. Now we'll come back after 60 minutes and see how much the phone is charged after 1 hour. So as you can see, after 1 minute, the phone is at 90%. So let us write that down. And while touching the phone is not that warm. It's just a little warm, but not that warm to my hand. So after 1 hour or 60 minutes, the phone is at 90%. Now we'll come back when the phone is 100% charged. So as you can see, after 1 hour and 29 minutes, we can call that almost 90 minutes, our phone is 100% charged. So let us write that down and stop the timer. It took about 1 hour and 29 minutes, so we can call that about 90 minutes. And on 90 minutes, our phone is completely charged. And remember, this phone comes with a battery of 6000 mAh, so the massive battery, so the 33 watt charger definitely charge this phone fairly quickly. 1 hour and 30 minutes, this phone got charged to 100%. So there we go, this was my charging test of the Poco X3, and we use the charger that we got in the box. Use the charger that we that came in the box, and we also use the cable that came in the box. And the phone took about 90 minutes to fully charge. And we started at 1%. After 10 minutes, the phone was at 23% charge. After 20 minutes, it was 43% charge. After 30 minutes, I think it was at 57% charged. I'm not sure, but you will see that in the video. After 60 minutes, that is 1 hour, the phone was 90% charge, and after 90 minutes, it took about another 30 minutes to charge the last 10%. So 100% was charged in 90 minutes. So 1 hour 30 minutes for a 6000 milliamp hour battery is really nice. So the charging time of this phone is really nice. So there we go. This was my video. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.